I was explaining this is like a zero yard superadded of this, and the binary equivalent of this would be 1111 for F and 0101 for 3. If I remove this 3 from here, it would still be a valid number with the binary equivalent 0000 and 1111. But I got F3. So what is happening over here? After this, so from the 10th instruction, it would be this number would be stored in memory location 32H. After that, what I am doing? Move A comma @R1. @R1 means the memory location, what is stored in R1, 32H. So @R1, so the data content in memory location 32H would be moved in A instead of, what is the data content in 32H? It is 0F3H. So in A, we should get 0F3H. Remember at the start, we need an org 000H to indicate the program counter from where it has to start, and end is to end the program. So to execute, we have to first build the program, check for errors, then rebuild the program, check for errors. Then you have to go and click over here, which is start and stop debugging. Yes, my code is within 2K. Okay. So take a minute and look at this screen, what is given over here. At the left hand side of this, I can see registers R0 to R7 and their values. As I said in the introductory video, like we have only 8 names for these registers, you need to know which bank is selected, like to know the location of the data which is being stored. For example, if bank 0 is selected, the memory location of R0 would be 00, whereas if bank 1 is selected, then the memory location of R0 would be 08 and not 00. As you can see, initially A register, B register have 00 values, stack pointer is 07. All this thing is not necessary right now, and you can see the PSW as well. Yeah. Let's take it down. Yeah, parity 0. See, as you can see over here, RS is 0, which means like the bank 0 has been selected. Yeah. So to start, this is the code which we wrote. To go to the memory location, click on this memory. Now as we are using 30, 31 and 32, we'll write, and there is a data memory. So D colon 30H, enter. As you can see, this is the first location is 30, the next is, this is 31, 32, 33, 34 and so on. Remember, it's D colon 30H, okay. So to run it, this would be step by step one line running. This would step the current line and run the next program. These two are right now not required, so leave it. This would be running in a single step. So we don't want a single step execution since we are in the introductory part. So we'll run it step by step. Moving, clicking once. See, as you can see, this green line means this instruction has been executed. What is this instruction? Move A, 30. So what we can expect is 30H in A. As you can see, A has 30H over here. Next is move A, 30H. So what is there in the memory location 30H? 00. As you can see, there is no hashtag sign over here. So we expect A to be filled by 00H. As you can see, A has been filled by 00H. Next is move R0, hashtag 31H. So R0 should be filled by the value 31. Let's check it out. Yes, R0 has been filled by 31H. Next is move A, R0. So A should be filled by 31. A is filled by 31. Yes. As you can see, 31, if you convert the binary equivalent of this, you will find odd number of 1s, and parity flag over here, as you can see, is 1. Next is move R1, 32. Okay, so R1 should be filled with 32. Oh, sorry, it was move A, @R0, sorry. So @R0, what is in stored in R0? R0 is stored with 31H. @R0, move A, @R0 means moving the data content which is stored at the rate 31, at the rate 31, see 31 is 00, so A should be filled with 00. Yes, A is filled with 00. Next is, okay, as I was saying, move R1 comma 32H. It's not clear. The 9 instruction asks me to move 32H in R1. Okay, so let us execute this 32H in R1. As you can see, 32H in R1 comes. Next is move the number 0F3H in memory location 32H. Okay, 32H, okay. So let us execute this step. Let us check the number. As you can see, 30, 31, 32 has been filled by F3. After this, what is the instruction? Move A comma at the rate R1 means what is there in R1? 32. So at the rate R1 means the data contents of the memory location 32, that is F3, should be moved in A. What is currently stored in A is 00. So after this execution 11th step, we should get 0F3H in A. As you can see, we get F3 in H. That is the last step. So after executing again this, we should get a error 65, which is the end of the program. So I hope this is clear from this instruction. This is just a general overview. The next program would be a much complicated one. So I request you to just note it down and go through it once. Thank you.